There we go, then it's the customary post game interview with Coach Clunt. Round of applause. And then that's Mr. Campbell.
Yeah!
Once again, I'll ask you what the start of the game was because I missed the first period and a half, so it was a run from on that one, so that was much.
We played really well there in the first two periods. We controlled the game and we kind of sat back a little bit in the third. They came at us and you know they were a good skating team. They used their speed and they took advantage of it in the third period. We talked about it. We got to stop giving away leads like we have for the last few games. We're winning by two. We got a chance to win a hockey game and put ourselves in a position at the end to have another tie. But you know, the boys overall played pretty well. And, now we gotta go get ready for tomorrow in Sheffield. It's gonna play hard there again for 60 minutes this morning.
Once again, is it hard to get the team properly motivated for a game like this? I mean, it was a dead rubber. Both teams were definitely out of it. How hard they come to, I think. And we're definitely out of it. Is it hard to motivate the team to get playing? Or is it hard because you've got a game next week and you don't want to lower your standards, sort of thing?
Yeah, I mean, we got three big games coming up. We got a big game in Fife Tuesday, then Saturday night in Edinburgh, and then back home Sunday against Fife. So we got three big league matches coming up. And we just want to make sure we come out of this weekend with no injuries. And the way to do that, sometimes you can't let up, you can't stop playing, and you got to play hard. Because if you go out there and you take it easy, you can get a hit, you get bumped, and fall the wrong way. Get hurt, so but we don't. You know, we're going to play hard tomorrow, finish it off tomorrow night, work hard, and get ready for Tuesday. Like I said, you can't just turn it on and off. You can't just not show up and then show up Tuesday. You got to keep playing hard, get ready for Tuesday night.
Well, considering it was a dead rubber, it was a pretty feisty game for one. So I mean, I saw the last period and a half. I didn't miss any of the fights and all that. There was a few elbows going in. Tomo was doing his customary YMCA pressing and doing the old Macarena, going mad at your referee. I mean. What sort of things was you saying to him on the bench? Were you saying anything to him?
To Tomo?
Yeah.
No, I mean, I just, you know, he's doing his job, and, you know, I played him for 2 years, so I've seen it before. I know what he does. That's Tomo. I mean, he's a passionate guy, so that stuff happens. But, no, we're just worried about what we do on our side. And, you know, we played them hard. We knew it was going to be an intense game. And, we knew they were still alive for the Challenge Cup. Before the game, and if we were to beat them or tie them, we probably would knock them out. So the guys came out and played hard. And you know, us in Coventry, ever since the ownership's taken over, it's been a pretty good rival. So the games have been really intense, and they've been really good playing against each other.
It seems to be no love lost between the two teams. Is it one of those things where you want to really get one over the ownership, or is it just you just don't like each other that much?
Well, I think ever since you know, they obviously they took over, it's great they took over of our team and kept the team here. But I mean, the guys know they want to prove a point. They, you know, obviously it's the same ownership watching, so they want to play well and play hard. And we want to beat that group. They don't want to get beat by us. And I think it's going to be a rivalry here for years, and it's nice to see because it's good for the fans. The games are intense and they're feisty, and that's what you want.
What do you think of McKinney's proper introduction to Elite League? I mean, I know he had the game before, but I mean, this is his full-blown debut, sort of thing.
Yeah, I know. Spoke to Andy last week, and we're trying to get him to come play with us in Fife during the week. And he wanted to make the jump, and he wanted to come. And I said, you know, we got two Challenge Cups. And, you know, you can wait till next week and come make your start, maybe stay back down. And he said, well, I'll talk to Tommy, and then he called me back and said, I don't want to stay, I want to come play for you guys in Challenge Cup games. And you can see, he brings a lot of grit and he comes to play. And he played hard tonight, even though the game didn't mean anything. He came up and showed up. And, you know, give him a lot of credit to drop the gloves with their tough guy over.
Was that an instruction, or was it just him trying to make a mark in the league?
No, I mean, we'd never tell anyone to go fight anyone. And I think it's just the way he plays the game. He's intense. And, maybe, you know, he wanted to make a name for himself. He went out there and did a good job. Good on him to show up. That's all you got to do in fights. If you show up, people respect you, and he did that for us.
Nice little porno task coming there now, folks. You look like you're going to be on a porn film now, doing a bit of plumbing or something like that.
I don't know if I'll be porn. No.
So we'll round of applause for Sylvan there. And welcome to Derek Campbell, man of the match tonight. So Derek, you knocked his head off, so can you give us a bit of insight into the fight tonight?
No, I think he just, probably just one of those things, I guess. Probably just both of our jobs, really, and I think it was the right time to do it, so. You know, I mean, both guys did pretty good.
You've been enjoying your time in Hull then, I mean, it's a completely different setup to what you normally use. I mean, obviously the teams that you've been playing for, you've been championship winning teams and that, and we're sort of like in mid-table, bottom of the table sort of thing. Is that a different thing for you to come into?
Well, not really, because I played in Newcastle, but no, it's just different challenges. Maybe in the top clubs, you're expected to win, but here it's, you're always battling to win, and we're doing a pretty good job right now, but just got to tighten up at the end of the game, really.
Yeah, it's the last period are pretty much killing us at the minute. It's nothing that the players are really doing properly wrong. I think it's just one of them things where the teams are taking advantage of us in the last period. They're sort of like running all over us in the last period. How do you see it?
I think I see it as, our coach sees it. When you have your top five players out and we get scored on, it's not really anything to do. There's no excuses for that. And as the top players, you gotta be better, because we're not going to win games. I don't dress to tie games or losses. So, I know Pute's the exact same way, and I know those guys in a row are the same way, but you just got to do it.
So, obviously, you're winning the fans around this season, because, I mean, as you usually come into, well, you used to get booed because we didn't like you sort of thing. But you've sort of like won the fans around. How well is it to actually see us cheering your name now for a change instead of giving you abuse?
Yeah, it's great. It's great to hear you guys chirping other players on the other team. But, I'm really happy that fans are taking a liking to, myself and the rest of the team. But, like I said, we're here to win, and we got to start winning games. These ties aren't good enough.
Did you used to wait coming to Hull, and some of the abuse you used to get from us up in Epcot when you was Manchester and Newcastle and stuff like that? I mean, I've given you a few roastings in the past, I know that for a fact.
I've taken a lot of stick from you guys, but, that's great. It's even though, players like playing here because of, the fans, I guess it's the same as going into Coventry. You always like playing if you're that type of player because the fans are on you, and it just sort of elevates your game. Or sometimes you guys get the best of us and we take super penalties, but that's the way it is.
I know David Longstaff used to love coming here from Newcastle. I used to think he was like that, really. And he always used to sit next to the plexiglass near where we are, so he could actually hear the abuse.
Yeah.
We had a few of them stories.
Yeah, a lot of you. We'd come in the dressing room and just start giggling at us, especially Andre, how you guys used to abuse him. And Bobby's a funny guy, so very good.
So once again, round of applause once again for David Campbell, man of the match. Tashi's coming on with the lads, and a few of us doing it now.
Yeah, there's quite a few guys coming along, and some of them have been coming up for a while, so no, it's nice. I mean, it's great going to football games in the morning, you get everyone staring at you with a mustache. You got some of my daughter's friends that don't even want to look at you. I don't think it looks very nice. So. Going in public's the hard thing to do with the mustache, but you know what, for a good cause, and it's a lot of fun, and that's all that matters.
Well, if you think I feel I'm going to sell tickets with this tash, and I'm going to get an Hitler tash for the last couple of days, and I'm going to go do the tickets with like Blakey and stuff like that. So that'll be a right laugh an hour, then we're back. There we go. Are we going to get a photo in the Old Daily Mail for it, get a bit of publicity for the team?
Yeah, I asked Kathy to take a picture of the guys that are growing the mustache so we can get it out there and let them know we're involved. Again, it's a great cause. We're having fun with it too, with the mustaches, and it's good.
Yeah, I think Brayhead's doing the same, aren't they? So when we play Brayhead at the end of this month, so they'll be like, it'll be every slump They'll be slug fight there, won't they, on their free again? There'll be slugs all over the place.
We need to see though, it's fun to see the other guys growing up too and taking part. There was a few guys signing the other team, and nice to see them. No, like, this is a great cause, and yours looks good, so maybe we should keep it.
Nah, maybe not. I don't know, so that's an old thing, yeah. So once again, round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, thanks for coming.